to smile.
Or Taylor will hurt you.
Yeah, pretend you're happy.
All right, go ahead.
Remember, I have on the heels.
Okay. Smile, Ma.
Don't make me laugh.
It's fine. Laughing's good. Then you're smiling. They have me all mic'd up.
Good luck, Jamie.
You're so fast.
Hey, I see you, Max.
Now I do.
Yeah, they went so fast. Anna, give me a hug. Nice smile, Mark. Galen, even better.
Let's do this thing, buddy.
Right.
Love you.
I love you.
Hey, sis.
Oh my gosh. Is that microphone hot?
Oh, I have no idea.
You just put it on me. It's probably recording. This is Gallagher.
It's still Hake.
I know.
Thanks, buddy. Your letter meant so much to me.
Sam, how's my tie? How's my tie? Is my tie fine?
Thank you.
say yes to each other in Christ. You know, it's a very special treat. These people often do something on Friday night different than this, but they're here to say that they love you, they support you, and they support your saying yes to each other for the journey of life. It's a good drama. Let's pray together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Let's praise together the glory of our God. Almighty God, hear our prayers for James and Taylor, who've come here today to be united in the sacrament of marriage. Increase their faith in you and in each other. And through them, bless your church with Christian children. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. I ask you to be seated and hear the readings that they chose out to hear themselves tonight.
Forsake you. Bind them around your neck. Write them on the tablet of your heart. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. On your own intelligence, do not rely. In all your ways, be mindful of him, and he will make straight your paths. Happy the one who finds wisdom, the one who gains understanding. Her profit is better than profit in silver, and better than gold in her revenue. She is more precious than corals, and no treasure of yours can compare with her. Long life is in her right hand, and her left are riches and honor. Her way are pleasant ways, and all her paths are peace. She is a tree of life to those who grasp her, and those who hold her fast are happy. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Brothers and sisters, finally, all of you, be of one mind, sympathetic, loving toward one another, compassionate, humble. Do not return evil for evil, or insult for insult, but on the contrary, a blessing, because to this you were called, that you might inherit a blessing. For whoever would love life and see good days must keep the tongue from evil and the lips from speaking deceit, must turn turn from evil and do good. Seek peace and follow after it. For the eyes of the Lord are on the righteous, and his ears turn to their prayer. The word of the Lord. So that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you. The Gospel of the Lord. I'm going to talk to the two of you for a while, but you can listen in. I'd like you to. The days you spent together, the time you chose to live together for a lifetime, coming up even today to not see each other till the time of the wedding. And you chose readings today, which are very challenging readings. You know, it'll just be nice and have fun and do what you want and stuff. No. It says, really, will you lay down your life? Will you give yourself to friends? And can people be friends whom you've just met, even?
In a lot of ways, the way you live together is going to make a big difference in how you treat other people. You know, we call that transfer. If you're all upset with each other at home, you slam the door, and she can go out and do brain surgery. Are you kidding me? Or are you going to go out and do lawn surgery and make sure everything's just the way it should be? But I'm serious in saying that, though, that in so many ways, we become a nurturer for each other in all the kinds of relationships we have. And in marriage, in a very special way, or we don't. Now, you've chosen to come to the church. This building has been around for 100 years. And the same kind of symbolism has been going on throughout. And each time, it is to say, God says, I chose you, you're important. Be with me, be my signs in the world, and live it out, and I'll be with you. We even talk about the marriage itself, not just as a civil contract. Oh, it's that. One of their best men, maid of honor, will be have signed with me on the certificate that will tell people that you're married. But it's more than that. It is the sacrament of Christ himself saying, I will seal this wedding. And I will be there for you as you work together toward your future, which God knows, you know. When people see the weddings of pictures of today, they're going to say things like, wow, that's really pretty. I wouldn't have a mommy or daddy if that wasn't so. These kids you're planning on having. Or so many other things. People who come here for the weddings think about their own weddings or wonder if they'll get married or everything in between. And we can idealize marriage into something that simply is undoable. And I'm invading your grasp because I'm not a perfect wife or husband. I'm not a perfect mother, father. Of course not. That's how we got made. It's a lot of imperfection in us, but also with some of those same ideals which can be reintegrated in our lives. So that as we go on, we take it as inspiring. To reach beyond ourselves in our own imagination. I think there's a lot of heroism in everyday life. I truly mean that. People trying to work together, trying to live together, trying to work it out, trying to believe in what God reveals. And you just saw earlier in the week that the Holy Father and the people in Switzerland got together to talk about Christian unity of Catholics and Lutherans. So the whole world is trying to get things together for you too. And you know that if that's only going to happen if the things that are really the salient points come true. Only if we really come truly to see that the Lord is here to feed us with his very self in the Eucharist, or that he comes among us to set us free. They've been walking for 50 years, and so many of those things they've worked out. You and I have lived in times of chaos, of reformation, all over the place. And people come up and say, how come you Christians, these all got different churches and different names on them and everything? I can't figure it out. Well, we can't either sometimes, you know. And so, in our own lives, are we open on the journey to carry it on and to say yes? Because the challenge of today is not just for the two of you to say yes in your marriage, but to all of us to say yes anew to the Lord who calls us and says, you are important. No such thing as unimportant. You make a difference. No such thing as indifferent. This is not because you have illusions of grandeur, it's because you are who you are, an instrument. You make yourself heard and known throughout the world. That doesn't matter. It's just simply what it means to be alive and to share our lives with each other. Thanks for inviting all of us to be here today. And thanks for all the love you've given to each other already in life and to the way you are going to go forward. You know, your marriage is going to be unique. It's the only one with you two. And it's the only one to come to understand what will that mean. And many people are going to look for their ring on your finger and they go, oh, How do they do that wedding thing? And they're going to listen. They're going to listen. And they're going to learn. So we have this wonderful big wedding party. We ask you all to come on up, and for you, and come on up with me to the altar, and we will have a wedding.
I had the mic up. Mic me up on the wrong side.
What? No,
don't worry about it.
Saying to you downstairs, mm-hmm. The whole thing of the Lucians and Catholics coming together.
Yeah.
It will be, as you say, what looks like the appearance of bread and wine, and in fact, Himself feeding us.
Yes.
And trust it.
Yeah.
It's
a very good question.
My dear friends, you have come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister and this community. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He's already consecrated you in baptism, and now enriches and strengthens you in a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and in lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Why don't you turn toward each other? Taylor and James, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
Yes.
I have.
And will you love each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives?
I will.
I will.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church?
I will.
I will.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, join your right hands. You know how you do that. And declare your consent before God and His church. I, James.
Take you, Taylor.
To be my wife. I promise to be true to you. In good times and in bad. In sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life. I, Taylor, take you, James.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you. In good times and in bad. In sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life. You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in His goodness fill you, your consent with His blessings. Strengthen your consent and fill you with His blessings. We ask this. One thing we also say is, when God has joined, people must not divide. Let's all say amen to that.
Amen.
Let's say it again.
Amen.
And let's stand up and hear it for him. Give him a round of applause. Fine. Now, you remember that business about the rings that I was talking about?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to bless them. Hold me in your hand. There you go. Lord, bless these rings, which these people will give to each other as a sign of your love and fidelity. You say, I will give you this ring. Amen.
Press her ring. Put her finger. And say, Taylor, take this ring.
Taylor, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father and of the Son.
In the name of the Father and the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Taylor, take this ring.
Take this ring.
Taylor.
James.
James. James, take this ring.
James, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Well, now that you're all married up, you want to give any talks or anything right away? Or you, no? Okay. Well, you're giving a talk, I'll tell you. You're giving a talk to all of us by your lack of cynicism, by your willingness to go into the unknown, and by knowing in faith that the God who made you is with you and loves you. Congratulations. Let's hear it again. You can all go back to your places now. Having heard God's word, we turn out to the Lord with our prayers and petition and pray.
For Taylor and James, who have committed themselves before God and God's people, for continued deepening love and respect for one another, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Church of God throughout the world, for those who share in the body of Christ and drink from the cup of salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all married couples, for those who are committed to one another, and for those who are in search of a lifelong partner, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of the world, for endurance in their quest for justice and peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here, and for our absent relatives and friends, for God's abundant blessing and providential care, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died in Christ, especially the members of our families, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God the Father, hear our prayer. Hear us, God the Son. Holy Spirit, hear our prayer. Mercy on your people, Lord.
That one.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For through your goodness, we received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, the work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness, we receive the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, that will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
As they accept and consider our hands for the praise and glory of his name, and good all his holy church.
Receive, we pray, O Lord, the offering made on the occasion of this sealing of the sacred bond of marriage. And just as your goodness is its origin, may your providence guide its course through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you have forged the covenant of marriage as a sweet yoke of harmony and an unbreakable bond of peace, so that the chaste and faithful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish the wonder of this twofold design, that while the birth of child brings beauty to the world, their rebirth and baptism brings increase to the church through Christ our Lord. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your glory. Without end, we acclaim indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation. Giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you, humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Bernard and Andrew, our bishops. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
Lord, in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, as we forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
I'd ask the rest of you to simply hold your hand out in a relaxed and comfortable way to bless these two with me. Holy Father, creator of the universe and maker of man and woman in your own likeness, source of blessing for married life, we humbly pray to you for this woman who today is united to her husband in this sacrament of matrimony. May your faithful blessing come upon her and her husband, so that they may together rejoice in your gift of married love and enrich your church with their children. Lord, may they both praise you when they are happy and turn to you in their sorrows. May they be glad that you help them in their work and know that you are with them in their need. May they pray to you in the community of the church and be your witnesses in the world. May they reach old age in the company of their friends and come at last to the kingdom of heaven. We ask this all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pretty big prayer, huh?
Yeah.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Again, for the kingdom, power, and glory are yours,
now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant the peace and unity of her to her in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you.
Let's share that with people around us.
Hi.
Peace to you both.
Peace.
You're great.
Peace. Congratulations.
Congratulations. Please. Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to enter under my roof, but only say the words, my soul is healed. Body of Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Receive that.
Christ.
Submit the quiet for ourselves, Taylor and James, and for all that the Lord has spoken to us in different ways tonight. Let us pray. Loving God, as we have eaten and drank the body and blood of your Son, help us to walk in his strength as the young couple in this marriage walk in theirs tonight, in the Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. You haven't done enough work yet, so I want you to hold your hand out again in blessing for these two. They need a lot of blessing, I'll tell you. May God, the Almighty Father, give you his joy and bless you and your children. Amen.
Amen.
May the only Son of God have mercy on you and help you in good times and in bad. Amen.
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit of God always fill your hearts with love. Amen.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you all, Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. I want you to see the Hagues. Let's just step out in fear in front of everybody.
Woo! We're married!